Imagine controlling your favorite device, your phone, your TV, even a video game, not with your hands, but with your mind alone. No clicks, no screens, no barriers. In 2025, Elon Musk's Neuralink just brought us a leap closer to that world by implanting its brain chip in a 9th human patient. Are we really on the verge of a Matrix-style reality where thoughts blend seamlessly with technology? Let's unravel the real story behind this groundbreaking milestone. Welcome to the channel that dives deep into tech revolutions that don't just change headlines, they change lives. If innovation fascinates you, tap subscribe and ring that bell, because what's happening at Neuralink could soon change what it means to be human. Chapter 1, Breakthrough Moment, Neuralink's 9th Implant. Elon Musk's neurotechnology venture, Neuralink, just completed its 9th human brain chip implant since the launch of its clinical trials in January 2024, a milestone that's more than just a number, 12. Not only was this the highest patient count yet, but for the first time, Neuralink performed 2 surgeries in a single day, proving its tech and medical teams are speeding up, not slowing down. The announcement, made via Musk's updates on X and official channels, marks a new level of readiness for broader clinical use. Chapter 2, how does Neuralink work? At the heart of Neuralink is a brain-computer interface, or BCI, a system designed to translate your thoughts into digital signals in real time. Here's how it works. The link chip, a coin-sized implant, is placed within the skull. It's connected to ultra-thin, flexible threads, each just a fraction of a human hair, that reach brain regions responsible for movement and intent. Wireless and seamless. The device is completely wireless, transmitting neural signals to computers, phones, and more. No bulky hardware, no external ports. Surgical precision. Threads are so delicate that only a robotic surgical tool can implant them safely, minimizing risk and maximizing accuracy. Battery and upgrades. The chip's internal battery charges wirelessly. And just like a smartphone, the system can receive software updates that could add new functions over time. This isn't just science fiction. It's a system that's already letting people control digital interfaces with their thoughts alone. Chapter 3, who gets the chip and what are they doing? Neuralink's trials focus on volunteers with severe paralysis from spinal injuries or diseases like ALS, people for whom regaining digital independence is life-changing. Since getting FDA approval for human studies in 2023, the trial has shown dramatic real-world potential. One patient, a paralyzed military veteran, can play video games using only his mind. He describes the experience as getting my spark back. Early volunteers are able to move cursors, type phrases, operate smart home controls, and play games, often for the first time since their injuries. With 9 successful implants and growing clinical momentum, all participants so far are recovering well and showing promising signs of independence restored by pure thought. Chapter 4, The Matrix in the Future, Humans Meet AI. But why stop here? Musk's vision for Neuralink reaches far beyond digital accessibility. His endgame is nothing less than merging minds with artificial intelligence. Future versions of Neuralink may allow instantaneous skill downloads, learning a new language or technique in seconds, just like Neo in The Matrix. The interface could enable real-time brain-to-brain communication, immersive virtual experiences, and memory sharing. In a world where AI is evolving rapidly, Musk argues that only by merging with it can humans keep pace and avoid being left behind. Right now, it's medical miracles for a few, but the roadmap includes restoring sight to the blind, speech to stroke victims, and even building telepathic communication between users. Chapter 5, Ethics and Controversy. Can we handle this power? Not all headlines are glowing. Neuralink's march toward the future is accompanied by serious ethical questions. Long-term safety. Can a device inside the brain remain safe for years? What about risk of tissue damage or device malfunction? Mental privacy. Turning thoughts into data raises chilling questions about brain hacking or surveillance. Social inequity. If such enhancements become available commercially, Will it create a divide between the augmented and everyone else? Animal testing. The company has also faced controversy and regulatory scrutiny for its treatments of animals in early experiments. Neuralink insists on a careful and ethical path forward, but public and scientific debates are certain to intensify as the technology matures. Chapter 6, what's next for Neuralink? By the end of 2025, Neuralink aims to have 20-30 patients enrolled in its clinical program, and that's just the beginning. Ambitions include expanding to more medical applications, vision, speech, and mobility, scaling up with international clinical sites and automation, with the eventual goal making neural interfaces as routine as laser eye surgery, exploring a world where thoughts, digital devices, and artificial intelligence are woven together for everyone. Loop is the real-life matrix almost here. Imagine changing the channel, chatting with a friend, or even exploring virtual worlds just by thinking about it. Would you plug in, or does that future unsettle you? Let's debate. Drop your thoughts in the comments. Would you trust a chip in your brain if it could unlock superhuman possibilities? If this story blew your mind, hit like and subscribe for the latest reports on humanity's wildest frontiers. Tap the bell so you never miss an episode, and share this with any friend who's ever wished they could live inside the Matrix. The future is beckoning, with brainwaves, not keyboards. Are you ready to connect? This is not just science fiction. This is science in motion. Stay curious, question everything, and remember, the next big leap may be a thought away.